Was Boston an example of a working system of national security? Joining me right now is Republican Congressman Jason Chaffetz of Utah. He's a member of the House Homeland Security Committee. Congressman, thanks for joining me. Let me get your reaction to what the president said today. Did the FBI and the Department of Homeland Security, did they perform their duties? Did the system work?
Don't know yet. Look, we're all cheering them on that they're doing their job now. But there were two things that bothered me. As soon as the bombing happened, we had officials locally and from the feds saying, oh, this is an isolated case. This was just one person involved. We didn't know that. In fact, I think the starting point should be it might be part of a bigger, broader plot. And I do think we have to go back and review what happened. We need to look at the immigration status. We need to look at the fact of how the Russians shared this information. We've got to look at all of this. So I think you have to have a starting point. When you've got three people dead, over 200 people injured, people have lost limbs, and we had one of the biggest terrorist attacks we've had on the homeland, your starting point is, hey, everybody did their job and everybody did great. That's not your starting point. Your starting point is, this is unacceptable. We will not stand for it. We will get to the bottom of it, and we will not rest until we figure it out. That's your starting point.
Of course, it could be that that's his starting point behind closed doors and in front of the national stage, the international stage. He wants to deliver a different message, but I take your point. You serve on the House Homeland Security Committee. What's the latest that you're hearing on whether these two acted alone? We have female DNA found on one of the pressure cookers that were cautioned that that doesn't necessarily mean anything, but authorities are looking into possible connections with a Canadian boxer, somebody who became a militant. He was killed by Russian forces last year. What are you hearing in your briefings?
Well, look, it stretches the imagination to think that these two kids simply went online, watched a couple videos, and then put together some very sophisticated bombs to the degree that they did, the way they executed it. Again, I think that leads us to believe that there were others involved, that somehow these two kids went awry and they got trained, they got information, they were radicalized, and that's what the officials are diving deep into now. I recognize we're just over 2 weeks out. We got to let them do their job. It's going to take them weeks, perhaps months, to get through that. We're cheering them on. But, Mr. President, the starting point should be an intolerance that this thing happened.
Congressman, you argue that the Boston terrorist attacks are an example of how we need a better immigration system, but weren't the gaps here more intelligence issues, especially what Russia told the FBI and the CIA and whether or not the FBI, and not whether the FBI should have kept tabs on Tamerlan? How does this have to do with immigration?
Well, I think it really has to go back to Homeland Security. One of the things we're going to have to look closely at with the immigration debate and everything that's going on is asylum. You have some people who come here, they claim asylum because they worry that they're going to be persecuted. They're taking welfare and other types of public assistance because they can't afford anything, yet they're able to get airline tickets to go back to that region. While they may not have gone back to the very specific place, I think we need a timeline and some details as to the family members, how they came over here, how they were able to stay over here, how did they afford to go over there into an area that they said they were going to be killed or persecuted if they went back to. That doesn't quite add up. When the Russians then add some intelligence, you have a domestic dispute. All of these things should have been shared at the local effort. And that's the last point I guess I'd make, Jake, is did the feds, did they share that information with the counterterrorism folks there in Boston who are very competent? But if they don't get the information, then they're not able to act. And that's one of the big worries in this specific case.
And finally, Congressman, I know that you've been very involved in the Benghazi investigation. There are reports that some in the State Department are being prevented from testifying on Benghazi. The president today said he was not aware of the reports and would look into it. I want to play what a spokesman for the State Department said on the matter yesterday.
We think that we've done an independent investigation, that it's been transparent, thorough, credible, and detailed, and that we've shared those findings with the U.S. Congress.
And that should be enough.
I know you don't think it's enough, but do you concretely know of whistleblowers that are not being allowed to speak to House investigators?
What they need is to have good attorneys and good representation. The problem, the challenge we're having the State Department at the moment is these whistleblowers are unable to necessarily get the legal representation they need because these people need a certain degree of security clearance. What is absolutely clear through this is the administration has not been transparent. We have four dead Americans. We had injured people. There's nobody that's been brought to justice. The State Department, the White House, they have not shared this information with Congress. Chairman Daryl Issa has said we're going to have hearings, and those are going to happen sooner rather than later, and it's going to expose a whole lot of this that the administration says this is done. It's not done, Jake. There's a lot more to it.
But just a yes or no, do you concretely know of specific whistleblowers? Do you know of them?
Yes.
You do. Okay. Thank you, Congressman Chaffetz. Appreciate your time.